The following program deals with a controversial subject. The theories expressed are not the only possible interpretation. Viewers are invited to make a judgment based on all available information.
Hampton Court has a history of being haunted. The doors could actually have been thrown open by something paranormal.
Oh my God, I'm recording. I am on record.
It appeared to be reaching out for her.
It was a freaky thing.
Something was standing right in front of me.
Almost like a laughing, growling, mocking kind of voice.
There was an overbearing presence of evil.
There were these lights and these voices going on.
The hair stood up on the back of my neck.
We were scared as hell when this first started.
Yep, there went one.
So there's this figure in white that's moving through the wrecking yard.
Ooh, phantom fog.
I could feel it all around my body, under my clothes.
Ooh, something just touched me in the middle of the back, right?
Oh my God. I couldn't really believe what I saw.
Ghosts, are they real or not? From the invention of the earliest photographic devices to the latest home video cameras, believers have pointed to images like these as proof. Could they be haunting spirits, phantoms, the dead reaching out to the living? Or are some simply the result of camera tricks by clever hoaxers eager to convince millions hoping for evidence of life after death? In this program, you will see the most compelling cases ever presented of what many say are ghosts caught on video. You will hear from scientists, computer imaging experts, and the eyewitnesses who shot this chilling footage. Are we seeing spirits from beyond the grave, psychic projections, or something much more explainable? You decide for yourself as we examine the best ghost cases ever caught on tape. Can a ghost really be captured on videotape? Photographers all over the world have tried, and some of the ghost-like images they have collected are definitely mysterious. These are among the most fascinating sightings experts are now examining, and some of the most talked about ghost photos that have been amassed for decades by ghost hunters, collectors, and enthusiasts. And they've inspired a populace now armed with camcorders and other high-tech video devices to try to record them on tape. What you are seeing here is arguably one of the most compelling ghost videos ever shot. This ethereal humanoid figure appears to be closing fire exit doors at the former castle of King Henry VIII in London, England. Closed-circuit security cameras at Hampton Court Palace caught the eerie apparition in late 2003.
Hampton Court has a history of being haunted. There's no question about that. People have experiences at Hampton Court.
Top parapsychologist Lloyd Auerbach says that strange environmental conditions, either from nature or from a ghostly presence, have been detected at the palace, which has a tragic history involving horrific deaths, imprisonments, and even beheadings.
Richard Wiseman, a colleague of mine in England, set up a major investigation there and did find some unusual, well, natural phenomena that accounts for some of the experiences, at least. I don't believe they account for all of them. But between electromagnetic fields and low-frequency sound, which can cause people to experience unusual sensations and even hallucinations.
However, the events surrounding the extraordinary filming and the entity caught on camera were not hallucinations. The palace security staff had become concerned about fire exit doors that flew open on consecutive days for no apparent reason. After closing the doors the first time, palace guards reviewed the security camera footage and were surprised to see the doors swing open with no one in the vicinity. But when the doors inexplicably opened the next day, the guards reviewed the security footage again and were astonished to see this frightening entity clearly stepping into frame, pulling on the two door handles. Auerbach's colleague Wiseman has told the World Press he believes this is one of the best ghost images ever presented because it's not ambiguous and clearly a solid figure, not blurry and not a reflection. Also, it's doing something that, quote, has an effect on the real world, closing heavy doors. In addition, it remains an unnerving mystery why the ghostly figure looks transparent, showing what could be a skeletal structure, and why the spooky face in the Hampton Court video seems unnaturally white and simply doesn't look human. Interestingly, in 2006, another ghostly image was recorded by a security camera at a court of a different kind, the Lincoln County Courthouse near Charlotte, North Carolina. Staff working there reported seeing ghostly figures, and this eerie apparition of a woman seemingly writing on a notepad could be proof that the courthouse is indeed haunted. Security staff there told the news media that as the courthouse was closing for the day, their attention was drawn to a mysterious image of a person seen on the monitor showing the clerk's office. When two security guards were sent to the locked room to investigate, they seemingly walked right through the figure behind the counter, as the video recording shows. As the room grew dark at sunset, the image vanished after lasting more than 20 minutes. Five people in all saw the image live on the TV monitor as it was recorded. Astonishingly, yet another surveillance camera captured a baffling, ghostly image in July 2002 at an auto wrecking yard in Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. Could this startling video actually show the ghost of a young woman killed in a terrible auto accident, like the victim's father believes?
There was a man whose daughter died, and the car apparently was at the wrecking yard, and somehow thought that that was his daughter, and that, I believe, may have been very much wishful thinking.
The ghostly footage was shot at Puckett's Wrecking Service, where an employee saw this translucent figure appear right in front of her eyes on the security system's monitors. The video image appears erratic because Puckett's surveillance camera records only a few brief frames per second. While Lloyd Auerbach doubts there's anything tangible pointing to the ghost's identity, he does find the footage itself compelling.
The fact that the witness actually saw the figure on the security camera, on the monitor, at the time that the footage was being shot is interesting. It means that this figure was reflecting light. It means that there was actually something physically present.
Though some skeptics have claimed the figure could be an unexplained video artifact or the product of a cleverly staged event, the footage remains a baffling enigma still being studied by paranormal experts around the world. But this isn't the only compelling ghostly image filmed near a wreck that was involved in a dreadful car crash. November 1998, Pawling, New York. 58-year-old grandmother Rose Benvenuto had a horrific car accident when she swerved in an effort to avoid a stray dog.
I hit the railing, the airbag inflated, and I don't remember much else.
Looking at her wrecked car, you'd never guess that anyone could get out alive. But in fact, Rose walked away with hardly a scratch.
I guess it was a miracle that I did survive.
Rose believes that this provocative and chilling photograph may explain what saved her life. It was taken by Sharon Boo, a photographer at the local fire department.
I've taken hundreds and hundreds of photographs, but I've never come across anything like this.
Following her normal procedure, Sharon photographed the wrecked car from several different angles. But it was only in this shot that something inexplicable appeared.
This photograph contained a ghostly figure outline of a person. You could see through the ghostly figure and still see the automobile.
As incredible as it sounds, both Sharon and Rose believe the image in the photograph is indeed a ghost, one that saved Rose's life.
I feel she had an angel looking over her shoulder.
Was this mysterious image simply a camera trick or something Sharon created when developing her photo?
I do not develop my own photos. I just take them to a one-hour photo developing and have them developed right away.
In fact, the ghostly outline does appear on the negative of the film, surely a mystery and difficult to fake.
If someone did say that this is a hoax, I have to differ with them. Since I am here, I have survived that accident. There is this proof on the photo.
Colorado Springs, Colorado, 1996. Alleged ghosts caught on tape are said to take on many shapes and forms. This video of mysterious moving lights is from a security camera set up outside the home of Stephen Lee.
Well, we were scared as hell when this first started because never in my life have we had anything like this happen to us, not even remotely.
Lee and his family became concerned when they began to see strange apparitions.
We've had so many things happen here that's so unexplainable that what would shock you is pretty much normal, everyday things to us, you know.
Look closely at the tape. Rather than burglars, Lee caught something much more puzzling, bizarre lights appearing in front of his home.
They went through all these trees out in here and then out by my satellite dish here and then just zigzagged all around. They kind of hovered in front of the camera for a while, you know, like I was looking at the camera lens.
Notice how unique the lights seem. They swim back and forth, leaving a trail in their wake like miniature comets. Here, two of them merge into one, then disappear. These strange lights are called orbs, says university professor and ghost hunter Renee Horath.
They're balls of energy that actually reflect light and that move around, and we associate this with spirit phenomena. It is interesting also that the orbs come in different shapes. That is, I would say, the most common type of apparition that we get.
Apparition or not, Tim McHugh, a top visual effects expert whose work has been seen on The X-Files, finds these lights baffling.
It seems to be a reflection of a light somehow, or an intense light burned over a scene, but I can't explain how it was done.
And other unexplained orbs are apparently recorded on tape all over the world. Sao Paulo, Brazil, 1998. This home video was shot by a 10-year-old boy. It shows a mysterious glowing light hovering over a suburban neighborhood. You can see the orb move from one side of the street to the other, close to houses and light poles. It moves slowly, deliberately. Michio Keiku, professor of theoretical physics at the City University of New York, finds this video perplexing as well.
Obviously not something done by a flashlight or a spotlight, because it seems to have an intelligence. It seems to have a guiding pattern.
But all that glows might not be ghostly. Gettysburg, Pennsylvania, March 1999. These headlight-looking lights were videotaped by Dave Oster, president of the International Ghost Hunter Society, at a site in Gettysburg, Pennsylvania, where ghosts of fallen Civil War soldiers supposedly have been seen.
In Gettysburg, there was over 50,000 soldiers that was wounded, killed, or missing in action. A lot of them had unresolved issues, unfinished business.
However, can we really be sure we're not looking at a camera defect or even a hoax to perpetuate a possible myth about alleged Gettysburg ghosts? Oster, for one, is adamant his video is genuine.
The orbs of light, the balls of light, are souls of the departed who are still earthbound. And that, to us, says it's life after death, as a soul, as a spirit.
But special effects expert McHugh remains skeptical.
I don't see any evidence of ghosts in this piece of film here. These are lights that are either superimposed or shot independently of the background. It could be done with a piece of glass at an angle in front of the lens, reflecting light off to the side. And also, there's no light from these hitting the trees. The exposure on the tree seems to be the same with or without the mystic lights.
Despite McHugh's suspicions, Oster remains convinced what he's captured on tape is hard proof of the afterlife, and he welcomes further investigation from the scientific community. Of all the intriguing images of alleged ghosts caught on tape, some simply are so fantastic they seem right out of a horror movie. In this bizarre video, many people see a face appearing in the glass part of this clock. The investigator who shot this video ardently maintains it's not a ghost, but a demon appearing. And he also contends that this demon is talking. Listen.
You must leave the business here.
The tape was shot in Venice, California in 1992. Why would the videographer insist these images are demonic? The evidence in question was captured by Reverend James Michael Stanton.
One thing that I noted immediately upon entering this house in Venice, California, was a feeling of just pervasiveness of evil that could be felt within the house. And there was like a strange, radiant light coming out through the bathroom door. And so I had gone into the bathroom at that time with a small handheld video camera. And as I entered in, these voices started getting louder and louder. The thing began just mocking me and laughing and growling. And what eventually happened was I began to run out of tape on the camera, and I set it down on the sink, and I turned to go out of the room to get a handheld camera, and I heard this thing in the background just kind of like going like growling. And I looked, and the camera actually floated up into midair and was thrown and smashed against the bathroom wall. And unfortunately, we weren't able to use that camera again.
This is one of several controversial videos Stanton has presented. But he has spent years trying to persuade people that an evil spirit was inhabiting this clock.
You must What?
Though Stanton seems sincere, special effects expert McHugh, admittedly baffled, still thinks light coming from the window on the left might be helping to create the image.
It appears to me there can be some kind of movement making more or less light come through here as it's being reflected. And that's an unknown right now.
But halfway around the world, we found footage that could be the result of Hollywood-type animators using today's most sophisticated visual effects technology to render imaginary ghosts on tape. In the city of Prague, within the Czech Republic, we've uncovered evidence of an organized effort to fake ghost videos. Whether it is simply a ploy to promote tourism or to create evidence to bolster centuries of superstition and lore, these images seem digitally created. Perhaps no city in the world is a better location to stir intrigue in ghost footage than Prague. Centuries of war, executions, torture, and plague have left Prague, a city many believe to be haunted by the ghosts of its bloody history.
There are more ghosts reported in Prague in the history and the literature than anywhere else on the planet. When you think about ghosts, you have to think about Prague. You can't ignore Prague if you're serious about studying the subject of ghosts.
We traced a number of the locations seen in the videos to Prague's Museum of Torture, a morbid shrine to the grisly art of torture and execution. In this scene taped inside the museum, it appears a headless man is being forced to relive the torture of his death through the barbaric medieval method known as impaling. This supposed apparition was caught on tape just a few feet away, apparently suffering torture by means of a stockade. Special effects expert Tim McHugh believes the only mystery about the footage is how people could believe it.
This, to me, is very obviously computer generated. It really couldn't be more obvious. It's morphing, obviously pasted onto the sequence, and by the end, when you see it come over here, you'll just see it basically turn into some boxes as the head stretches up and drops back down. This image is, to me, obviously and painfully superimposed over the background.
But the Torture Museum was just one of several sites in Prague where fake ghosts have appeared on tape. A few miles away, yet another incredible apparition. A solitary skeleton slowly lumbering through a graveyard. We located the scene of the clip at Vyšehrad, Prague's oldest cemetery, where corpses have been collecting for centuries, body upon body.
People are pretty much jam-packed in this cemetery. Some people's tombs must have been moved around, reburied over. Tombs have been forgotten over the years, so possibly it's someone who has been displaced by a new occupant and finds himself with no place to go.
Not likely. Clearly, this skeleton appears to be a computer concoction.
what was once available only to Hollywood is now available to the public. And I think that the only people who would believe this is a real walking skeleton are those who don't understand computer technology.
Vissehrad Cemetery is also the scene of a number of hoaxed videos in which stone statues supposedly come to life. Here, a winged angel appears to dip a toe over the edge of a gravestone before morphing wildly out of shape.
There are stories of some of these statues being seen to move, of coming to some kind of life. There is a long history of statues interacting with the public in one way or another.
Also in Vissehrad, the bust at the bottom of your screen begins to change. The head becomes smaller, stretches back, and grows in size. Its lips move as if speaking, and finally it returns to its original position. In this creatively constructed scene, a female statue grotesquely transforms into a strange snouted creature of some kind. Next, it collapses into itself. Then, it seemingly returns to stone again. We went to Vissehrad and discovered both the morphing bust and its companion had vanished, leaving only the stone structures beneath them. Not one of the moving statues captured on video was anywhere to be found at Vissehrad. Like the others, the dancing angel too had vanished. But according to our Prague ghost experts, the only mystery is who is behind these digitally created ghost videos.
There's a couple of reasons that come to mind that might explain their presence. One is publicity, fame, money, possible tie-in to the tourist industry. Maybe some computer geek or a collection of them just wanted to practice their animation skills. Who knows?
Regardless of who fabricated the Prague ghost videos or what their motive was, some of them are, nonetheless, fascinating to watch.
Wow, this is great. Right off the bat, I have to say this is a computer-generated visual effect done with a 3D image of a bust. This is a very, very cool-looking effect, but to me it's obviously computer-generated. You can actually see the mesh pull apart as they morph from position to position. So I don't think you can rule out that it was created by a ghost, but if it was, he was definitely using a computer.
Even the dancing angel is believed to be the result of computer-animated wizardry.
It doesn't surprise me that the statue was never found because I don't think it was ever there, only in the computer.
And as this obviously hoax videotaped seance proves, even when real people are depicted in the Prague ghost videos, credibility is lacking.
This is a classic mistake that you make in visual effects, which is you've got three different actors in a scene. Because the event is not really happening in front of them, they don't all know where to look. And you've got this guy pointing over here, she's pointing over there. We can't quite tell where he's looking, but he's looking a little high. And the effect is very obviously pasted in after the fact.
Whether it's an alleged apparition, strange lights, or even incredible hoaxes, we've seen that many of these bizarre ghost videos can be artificially created using skill and even artistic talent. But does it really take a Hollywood-type special effects team to convincingly fake ghost footage? Today, with common technological devices, here's how even a couple of ordinary college kids can cheaply and easily make a very intriguing-looking ghost appear on tape. Students like Yuang Yang and Chris Hollisey can create state-of-the-art ghost videos with nothing more than video cameras, desktop systems, and their imaginations.
Well, at first hand, I thought that was something quite difficult, creating a ghost in a real environment. It's extremely fun. I absolutely love to do things like this.
Yang and Hollisey, animation students at California State University Northridge, worked for over a week to complete a believable ghost on tape. So how exactly is it done?
For the first step of creating ghost sighting, we needed footage, we needed a background, we needed a location where we would find the ghost.
Here you see Hollisey and Yang scouting their location and blocking the action that they will later animate. After dark, this corridor outside the engineering building on campus was videotaped, making it the first element of their ghost caught on tape. Next, they moved into the computer lab.
First, we digitized the footage film using a video editing software. And then we create a
the ghost using a 3D animation software. The part of the process that takes the most time is getting the effects to look right.
This compelling visual effect began as a wire-framed figure that is vaguely in the shape of a person. Then, some color and a glow were added to it to make it seem more ghostly. After that, Hollacy and Young animated the figure before it was combined with the videotape footage of the corridor. What seems to make it so convincing are the details the two students went out of their way to include, starting with a location that looks real and authentic. The time of day they shot their ghost video contributes to its believability. For the most part, we expect ghosts to appear at night. The darkness adds mystery to the scene as well. And in the actual animation of the ghostly figure, the stride of the ghost lends it believability too.
Melding the real with the unreal is the ultimate goal. You know, create seamlessly integrating the two is like the main goal.
That's precisely what Young and Hollacy have succeeded in doing. And others are doing so too. Take a look at this interesting video shot inside a suburban home. The translucent form descending the stairs is much like other ghost videos we've analyzed. But the difference is the ghost caught on tape is also the product of a student filmmaker. If you didn't know this, would you believe that it was an actual ghost caught on tape? So what does the future hold?
I think that the process that we used will be simplified in the future, and it will be made easier to do with the software.
As these two cheaply yet cleverly produce videos of ghostly forms show us, it's becoming increasingly difficult to tell the frauds from the real thing. Nevertheless, diligent ghost research is helping to prove that authentic, ghostly-like phenomena, witnessed and documented for years, can also be emulated and filmed in scientific settings. Many of the ghostly manifestations that serious researchers have consistently reported have been observed at this unique scientific laboratory. In this eerie, rarely seen footage, poltergeist researcher John Hutchinson is able to demonstrate exactly how poltergeist activity seemingly occurs at haunted locations. Hutchinson presumes that whether it's directed by intelligent spirits or not, electromagnetic fields are involved.
I believe poltergeist energy is a combination of electromagnetic, electrostatic fields and magnetic fields, interacting in a natural way, causing major effects to happen.
Hutchinson's research cautions people to consider that natural forces, as well as supernatural ones, could be behind these effects.
I have encountered people that have actually told me that they felt that their place was haunted, that they had things moving around as ashtrays, saw weird lights and that. I feel that my experiments have duplicated on many orders of magnitude of power the same kind of effects that people have seen.
This intriguing video shot by Hutchinson shows milk cartons floating in the air, metal rods bending, balls of light flashing, a spinning bowling ball defying gravity, a strange saucer floating up mysteriously, and a plastic bottle being squeezed by some unknown force. As spooky as it may look, this video footage does not show activity directed by spiritual forces. It was actually taped in Hutchinson's lab with what he has dubbed the poltergeist machine, and he has also invented the Hutchinson effect.
I feel what I'm doing with the Hutchinson effect is creating the artificial, I guess you can call it artificial, way that nature perhaps creates it on her own.
But there's nothing natural about this extraordinary footage recorded in the late 1990s. Some 1,500 scientists across Europe set up TV monitors to randomly receive video communication from beyond the grave without any cables, wires, or possible mode of reception. Other scientists involved in the research actually got voice recordings as well. Look at these baffling images and listen to the eerie sounds. Could this be a nursery rhyme from beyond?
Mary had a little lamb. Everywhere, then Mary went to the lamb.
Is this evidence of dead people returning, as the European scientists insist? Michio Keiku, professor of theoretical physics at the City University of New York, is suspicious of his fellow scientists.
The dead don't give us information on these tapes that can be used to prove their validity. Either this is really communications from the beyond, from the dead, or perhaps it's nothing but a videotape that's being placed inside a television camera.
Professor Keiku suggests popular notions about ghostly contact inspired by our entertainment industry should not be taken so literally, but rather should encourage us to duplicate such claims in controlled tests.
Some people believe that perhaps the ghosts can communicate to us via our television sets. And if you saw the movie Poltergeist, that's exactly what happens when the little girl says, "They're here." Well, I would be more convinced if you get a television set that has no power, that has no visible signs of a VCR, no antenna, then you could say that the television set is lighting up all by itself and is communicating with the dead.
But attempts to document definitive spirit phenomenon on film at respected scientific institutions have a long history. For example, in the 1970s, investigators from a research society named Surratt insisted their experiments revealed real ghosts at work. The ghosts are said to be making this pen write by itself. This matchbook move by itself, and this chain miraculously interlink. What are we to make of all this perplexing, seldom seen Surratt footage?
Just because phenomena looks goofy or sensational doesn't mean that it's not real. All I can make of it is that it's just as likely, it's probably more likely that it's not real than it is that it is real because of how goofy it is. But I know from experience that some ghosts have a good sense of humor.
There's nothing humorous about this ominous image recorded at a Moore Park, California residence in September 1989. This mysterious black apparition was captured by videographer Daniel Hobbit.
You can't explain it, but you just know it's real.
Hobbit has spent many years trying to capture compelling evidence that ghosts are real. He shot this eerie video in the home of a very frightened couple, convinced they were living with a disturbed spirit or entity.
They were experiencing strange occurrences in their house, in particular this one guest bedroom upstairs. Doors closing and pictures being thrown off the wall, and crying and voices coming from this particular room upstairs.
Despite the family's refusal to ever enter the room again, Hobbit braced himself and went in alone with his video camera. Once inside, Hobbit said he felt that some force was directing him to an antique picture on the wall. The picture was a present from the husband's dead mother.
I was not alone. A black, transparent, shadowy mass of some sorts, of someone or something standing by the bed. I remember the look on the husband's face. He stands up and he's pointing at the television, shaking his head, going, "My God," he says, "that's exactly what I saw."
Hobbit even caught the apparition reflected in a mirror. This shot persuades many top researchers that we are witnessing a real ghost on tape.
There was a scene where Mr. Hobbit panned the camera to the right and caught a reflection of the image in the mirror in the room. If it's an artifact, it's not going to be reflecting in the mirror in the same angle as it would be as if it was actually there. So that rules out an artifact immediately. So then what is it? It's an unknown.
Tellingly, the frightened family who lived in this home moved out and never came back. And the man who shot this video not only believes he captured a ghost on tape, but that it also should be a textbook example for proof of the afterlife.
The researchers in this field have devoted the last 20 years of their life had never encountered anything like this before. It's very rare to see what they had termed as a black articulating mass. After it was analyzed, dissected, I guess what I concluded was that it was truly an important piece of video, that perhaps I was meant to have captured it for some reason or another, not knowing then why. Maybe in some small way, with the mass interest that people have nowadays with ghosts. The Sixth Sense is a great example, the success of that movie. I think there's a curiosity that has sustained itself over the years when it comes to the supernatural, when it comes to the belief in ghosts. There are those who actually do believe but won't admit it. I think maybe in a small way, I'm hoping that maybe I've contributed in some aspect with the footage that I've managed to capture. Maybe I've offered a little more proof that maybe they do exist.
Academics in search of the truth about disembodied spirits have often taken their investigation to the places generally associated with ghosts, haunted houses. Alton, Illinois, July 1999. This stunning video is said to show a ghostly mist haunting a now abandoned home. The mist was recorded in the historic McPike Mansion. Experts say many McPike family members and their servants have died there. Is this mist evidence of them returning? College professor Renee Harath took this astonishing video while staking out the McPike Mansion.
It was well known as being a haunted site, and I came to investigate here and went through the entire house and ended up down here in the basement. And it was intensely cold. In fact, it was so cold that I began to shiver to the point where I could no longer continue videotaping.
Yet it was 95 degrees outside and there wasn't a draft in the basement. There is no simple scientific explanation of what was caught on tape.
Oh, and you know what? I can see it changing directions. Just as I rounded the doorway, the mist just came at me. Literally came at me.
The eerie mist seems to thicken and envelop everything in the room, including Renee and her camera.
It was like my body was being buffeted. I could feel it literally under my clothes.
Harath's testimony, along with the video itself, have forced skeptics to admit that something mysterious was caught on tape in that alleged haunted house.
There is not only photographic evidence, but there's physical evidence that the camera itself, mechanically, was trying to see an image and lock on it, so it was picking up some kind of a reading.
What makes this tape more authentic looking than some of the other tapes is the fact that it's so amateurish looking. Obviously, these are not professional actors. Obviously, we're not talking about professional cinematography, and it does look as if something is jumping out at you.
As for Harath herself, she believes she was definitely face to face with a ghost.
There's a misconception that most people have about ghosts or spirits, and that is the fact that all ghosts look like people. Actually, mists are far more common for people to see than something that looks like a person. That's a paranormal apparition. I believe it was indeed a spirit or a form of it that particular spirit took on that particular day.
San Diego, California, 1994. Another video shot at a legendary haunted building, the world-famous Hotel Del Coronado, was recorded by researchers who set up their cameras to document ghostly phenomena being reported there. In the seldom-shown footage, you see a door close by itself, then open. Is this a ghost at play? Though intriguing, Tim McHugh doesn't think the video proves it.
The fact that you can't see the bottom of the door in frame leads me to believe that it could easily have been created by putting something, a rod in the bottom of the door, opening and closing it. This would be a lot more credible footage if you could see the entire door, top to bottom.
Investigation of the pixels of the image reveals what could be a shadow, an optical illusion, or what might be a suspicious device pushing the door open. But what about this footage, shot in the same room, of an armoire door flying open? A ghost? Or did some kind of hidden spring force it open? The door might have been secretly pushed from inside. How can we really know for sure what we're seeing? Especially when footage originates at places of business or tourist attractions.
I've never heard of physical things happening at the Del. It's always been seeing a ghost, hearing voices, or some more perceptual things. The fact that these things are caught on tape means that there is a physical component, typically, or a psychic projection component, whether it is from a ghost or from a person. But there is a physical effect on tape so that there is genuinely something really happening here, something worthy of investigation.
It's easy to manipulate something in front of an untrained eye. Unfortunately, the old line of the bigger the lie, the more the buy. There have been many well-known hoaxes perpetrated on the public. And the best case, of course, was the book and motion picture, The Amityville Horror. Even though it was exposed in major newspapers across the country, most people today still believe it was a real case.
Just like the excitement now being generated by the recently released Hampton Court ghost footage, Print and television journalists around the world became enthralled in 1998 with this previous ghost video supposedly showing a spirit appearing outside a British museum. But after Ghostbusters investigated that case, it was determined the museum security camera had actually videotaped a leaf blowing through the scene. Not surprisingly, news of the solving of the mystery never received as much attention as the original sensational headlines promoting the notion that the image was a ghost. Yet with more and more people and institutions armed with video cameras and other state-of-the-art imaging tools, it's likely that we will continue to see more and more reports of mystifying and largely unexplainable ghost videos like those coming from palace security staff, courthouse surveillance cameras, auto wrecking yards, emergency workers, frightened homeowners, town residents, dedicated ghost hunters, clergymen, scientists, professional videographers, and even highly objective college professors. Interestingly, some people in the academic community who've seen ghostly phenomena up close and personal believe that the best ghost cases, documented with footage, have the most potential to convert skeptics into believers.
As a ghost researcher, videotaped evidence is very important. It is one element of many, but what has occurred with the videotape evidence is now people that are on the edge or not quite believers or non-believers that are willing to accept reasonable evidence suddenly will view this and it sort of go through a transformation.